Currently, the vast majority of people have already had a coronavirus infection, and many people have post-acute COVID or long COVID. The antiviral properties of glutathione can help prevent the increased viral load, which is seen in particular with coronavirus infection. When I saw the prices for L-ascorbic acid in the US, I was shocked. $130 per pack. $130. How do you survive there at all? Hey! One of the common complications of coronavirus infection is asthenia or severe weakness, feeling tired all the time. In this video, I will talk about medications that can help relieve the symptoms of post-acute COVID or long COVID. Long COVID-19 refers to an illness in people who have either recovered from COVID-19 or have had symptoms of this infection for an extended period of time. For a long time, I didn't want to make a video about COVID-19. There is too much noise, misinformation, and the most brutal, often unreasonable pressure from the governments of many countries. There are a lot of questions and heated discussions about the need to get vaccinated, about the effectiveness of masks, about the economic consequences of general quarantine. Currently, the vast majority of people have already had a coronavirus infection. Someone even gets sick twice, and many people have post-acute COVID or long COVID, one of the main manifestations of which is asthenia. Remember, you cannot use this video as medical advice for your health. Consult your doctor or other healthcare provider and make decisions not out of fear, but weighing all the benefits and risks. Now let's move on to asthenia, its symptoms and treatment approaches. The term asthenia means absence of strength, vigor, or force. Asthenia is defined as prolonged fatigue when it lasts more than a month and chronic when it lasts more than 6 months. Let's talk about the symptoms of asthenia. Evidence shows that many of COVID survivors have significant ongoing health problems, including following: enduring tiredness, malaise, fatigue, reduced muscle function, recurrent joint pain and shortness of breath, impaired ability to perform vital everyday tasks, attention deficit and memory impairment, panic attacks, anxiety, brain fog and depression, heart palpitations and increased blood pressure, altered or perverted sense of smell and taste, their absence, hearing loss and vestibular disorders, etc. Let me know in the comments what symptoms you, your family members, or your friends and colleagues are experiencing after surviving coronavirus infection. Now we turn to medications that can help you cope with post-COVID symptoms and quickly restore the body. Each medicine has indications and contraindications. It is also important to take into account individual characteristics. Therefore, I must once again remind you, consult your doctor before starting therapy. The first medicine on my list is the strongest antioxidant, glutathione. Glutathione is a linear tripeptide protein with a sulfhydryl group, which contains three non-essential amino acids, gamma-L-glutamyl L-cysteinyl glycine. Low glutathione levels can lead to an increased susceptibility of the body to viral infections and weaken the immune system. The antiviral properties of glutathione can help prevent the increased viral load and subsequent massive release of inflammatory cells in the lungs, which is seen in particular with coronavirus infection. Deficiency of glutathione also leads to accelerated aging in humans and the development of many chronic diseases of the body. What is the effect of glutathione in the body? First, it plays an important role in protecting the cells of the body. Glutathione is a powerful antioxidant. An antioxidant is a substance that neutralizes the damaging effect of free radicals. Free radicals, oxidants, or oxidizers are particles, atoms, molecules, or ions, usually unstable, containing one or more unpaired electrons on the outer electron shell. Since they have free space for an electron, they always seek to take it away from other molecules, thereby oxidizing any compounds with which they come in contact. Second, glutathione supports the immune system and protects immune cells from damage. Glutathione molecules are capable of directly blocking the replication of various viruses at different stages of their life cycle. Third, glutathione is able to prevent cell damage by combining with toxic substances and their metabolites, alcohol, xenobiotics. Fourth, it increases enzyme and liver activity and promotes liver detoxification and regenerative activity. Fifth, it slows down the aging process of the body, improves the color and turgor of tissues, increasing the elasticity of the skin. Sixth, glutathione is used to prevent neurotoxicity, hepatotoxicity, and nephrotoxicity during chemotherapy with cisplatin or other related compounds. The list of indications for use is quite large. Liver damage, toxic including alcoholic, viral, drug, when using antibiotics, anti-cancer, anti-tuberculosis, antiviral drugs, antidepressant, and oral contraceptives, cirrhosis of the liver, pre-cirrhotic states, intrahepatic cholestasis, or stagnation of bile in the hepatic ducts, post-operative period to eliminate residual effects of anesthesia, chronic cerebral ischemia, encephalopathy including associated with liver failure, depressive and withdrawal symptoms, Parkinson's disease, Alzheimer's disease, consequences of traumatic brain injury and neurosurgical interventions, neuropathic prophylaxis during chemotherapy treatment with cisplatin or its analog, additional therapy to eliminate the consequences of chemotherapy, diabetes mellitus, diabetic neuropathy and angiopathy, thyrotoxicosis, ischemic heart disease, atherosclerosis, arthritis, poisoning of various etiologies, alcohol, drugs, heavy metals, etc., renal failure, nephritis, nephropathy, infertility, oligospermia and acinospermia, chronic bronchitis, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, COPD, pneumonia, pulmonary tuberculosis, skin diseases, psoriasis, vitiligo, atopic dermatitis, etc., and of course diseases caused by viral and intracellular pathogens. Even the sun has stains, and the wonderful medicine glutathione can sometimes cause side effects such as allergic reactions, gradual or sharp decrease in blood pressure, increased heart rate, dyspeptic disorders such as nausea, vomiting, upset stools, bloating, and increased body temperature. Glutathione should be used with caution in children and the elderly. There are only three contraindications: hypersensitivity to the active substance, pregnancy and breastfeeding. However, glutathione is not toxic to embryo-fetal development, and pregnant women can take the medicine, but only if it's absolutely necessary and under the direct supervision of a physician. Interaction with other medicines. It is not recommended to combine glutathione with tetracyclines, sulfonamides, sodium menadione bisulfide, vitamin B12, and calcium pantothenate. Glutathione cannot be combined with alcohol. Which glutathione should you choose? Of course, eating well can increase the level of glutathione in the body. Glutathione is high in asparagus, avocado, and walnuts. The amino acids needed for the synthesis of glutathione are found in meat, fish, and legumes. Cinnamon and turmeric are a source of glutathione reductase, an enzyme that synthesizes glutathione from glycine, cysteine, and glutamine. However, nutrition can provide the body with glutathione only to a limited extent. Why? It's simple. The human body, mainly the liver, produces 8,000-10,000 milligrams of glutathione per day. A healthy diet high in fresh fruits and vegetables can provide only about 150 milligrams of glutathione per day. Best of all are droppers with glutathione. 100% of the medication is immediately in the bloodstream. The course is 5 to 10 droppers. Glutathione should be administered slowly intravenously. You can choose Italian glutathione, Tationil, another Italian glutathione, Glution, the third Italian glutathione, TAD 600 or TAD, Chinese glutathione, Glathionil. I want to share with you one life hack. Before intravenous administration of glutathione, you must first introduce vitamin C, of course the one that is for intravenous administration. What is it for? Vitamin C is also an antioxidant. In my video Secrets of Vitamin C, I said that the protective cells of our body, or leukocytes, contain a high concentration of vitamin C. And this concentration decreases during stress or illness. Vitamin C protects the DNA, RNA of our cells from free radicals. And most importantly, it maintains glutathione levels and thus enhances the effects of glutathione. Glutathione in turn restores vitamin C. Therefore, before intravenous administration of glutathione, you should inject a solution of vitamin C. But be careful, do not mix glutathione with vitamin C in the same syringe. A link to the video about vitamin C is in the description box. I have two questions. Are vitamin C and ascorbic acid the same? And which vitamin C is best to inject? When I asked myself these questions, I found interesting answers. Ascorbic acid is an organic compound that our body needs to function properly. Ascorbic acid has four isomers. Isomers are the same in atomic composition and molecular weight, but differ in the structure or arrangement of atoms in space, and as a result in properties. So, out of four isomers of ascorbic acid, only one is biologically active, L-ascorbic acid or vitamin C. One of the isomers, erythorbic acid, isoascorbic acid, D-araboascorbic acid, is used as a preservative, food additive E350. Who knows what effect other isomers have on our body? In general, you should use L-ascorbic acid. When I saw the prices for L-ascorbic acid in the US, I was shocked. $130 per pack. $130! At today's exchange rate, it is 9,620 rubles. How do you survive there at all? In Russia, a pack of intravenous vitamin C costs 185 times cheaper, 50 rubles, or $0.70. If you are prescribed oral vitamin C, you should choose one with bioflavonoids or liposomal vitamin C at a dosage of 500 mg 2 times a day or 1000 mg 1 time a day. These forms of vitamin C will benefit your health. Let's move on. Glutathione tablets. Are they effective or not? Previously, it was believed that the most of the glutathione taken by mouth is destroyed in the GI tract under the influence of hydrochloric acid and intestinal juice. It was believed that glutathione was allegedly not absorbed when taken orally. However, this was an erroneous statement, and it was based on the 1992 study, The Systemic Availability of Oral Glutathione. The study showed that a single oral administration of 3 grams of glutathione did not increase the concentration of glutathione in the blood. However, the researchers made a mistake. They looked for free glutathione in the blood, but when ingested, glutathione quickly binds to transport proteins. After 20 years of misconception, in 2014, a study appeared that showed an increase in the level of bound glutathione in the blood after oral administration of glutathione. At the same time, the amount of free glutathione in the deproteinized fraction of plasma and blood cell fraction did not increase. Another interesting 6-month randomized, double-blinded, placebo-controlled trial analyzed glutathione levels on body stores in 54 non-smoking adults. Oral glutathione supplements were used at a dosage of 250 or 1000 mg per day. I quote the abstract of the article. Glutathione levels increased 17 and 29% in blood and erythrocytes respectively in the low dose group. At 6 months, mean glutathione levels increased 30-35% in erythrocytes, plasma and lymphocytes, and 260% in buccal cells in the high dose group. And now, two important conclusions. The first, in most cases, the increases were dose and time dependent, and glutathione levels returned to baseline after a 1-month washout period. Second conclusion, natural killer cytotoxicity increased more than 2-fold in the high dose group versus placebo at 3 months. From these two conclusions, we can follow the third conclusion. Glutathione is important in viral and bacterial infections, moreover for a long time and in high doses. Links to all studies are in the description under this video. Reduced or liposomal glutathione has better bioavailability. The daily dosage is 500 to 1000 mg. There is also a form of S-acetyl-L-glutathione on the market that is more stable in the blood and helps maintain overall glutathione levels. The daily dosage is 100 mg. Decide on the form and dosage of glutathione with your doctor and don't forget the vitamin C in front of your glutathione drip. That's all for today. In the next video, I will continue to talk about recovering from COVID-19. There will be many useful drugs and life hacks. Subscribe to my channel, turn on notifications and hit likes. This will help my channel a lot. Take care of your body and mind. Hey!